Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a closer look at the Shortcuts app for the Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So macOS Mojave is going to bring the Shortcuts app, it's been around for a while in iOS, to the Mac. It's not going to completely replace Automator. Automator can still do some things that Shortcuts can't, but there's going to be a lot of overlap. So I thought it was a good idea at this point to take an early look at exactly what it's like to use the Shortcuts app on the Mac. This is the very first beta, so it's still pretty buggy, but you can get the general idea of how you use Shortcuts to create automations on your Mac. So the Shortcuts app here has got a sidebar with different categories of the shortcuts that you create and a gallery and then a main area. Let's create a shortcut here. I'm going to start by going to All Shortcuts. It's going to list all my shortcuts and there's a plus button at the top. I'm just going to do some simple examples here. So let's create something that merges PDFs. So we'll call this one Merge PDF Files. And then I need to have some input from this. The idea is I want this to be a quick action where you can select some PDF files and activate this so that it merges the one you've selected. So I'm going to go to the settings here and then I'm going to set this as a quick action with services menu checked. Now here I can set it to receive any input from quick action. So I can select specific kinds of things to use like only images or files, but I'm just going to leave this as any for this simple example. And then what to do if there's no input. You can actually have it ask for files if there's no input. So I'll just leave this as continue right here. Now let's go to the actions and I could search for actions or I could browse through the collection here to look for things. So let's search for PDF and I could see here that there is make PDF. I'm going to double click that to add it and then it's going to make PDF from what? Well, I'm going to click here and I can select shortcut input. So the files that come in are going to be made into a single PDF. Now I need to save the file. So let's look for save and here's save file. I'm going to double click to add that. Ask where to save? Yes. Overwrite if file exists? No. Let's force a new file name. So now that I've got that done, I can close it. And if I look here under quick actions, I should see it listed. So there it is. If I want to go and edit it again, I can just double click on it and there it is. Now let's go and try to use it. So I've got a folder here on the desktop with some PDFs in it. Let me select all of these. Now I'm going to go to Finder and then Services and there's Merge PDF Files. Let's go and try that here and it's going to prompt me for the location to save it. So let's go back into that same folder, open it up, and you can see it creates a new file here that's the combination of all of those. Now I should be able to select those files, control click, right click or two finger click on the trackpad and under quick actions see it here, but I don't see it there right away. If I go to customize, then I'll see it here and I can select it and now that it's checked it will show up under quick actions. There it is. I'll also see it appear here in the preview area. So let's look at some other examples here. I've got one I created called Resize Image Files and it does the same receive any input from quick actions. It also says that if there's no input then ask for files and you can click here and have it ask for different things to select. Then it's going to do an ask for. So ask for is an action right here and you can click this I button here to get information about each action. So here this is going to display a dialog prompting the user to enter something, enter a number in this case. Then it's going to say resize and then the shortcut input here to size and I could do percentage or longest edge, that kind of thing, provided input. And that's the provided input from this previous action. And then it's resized but not saved yet. So then it's going to save the resized image. So everything gets passed through, ask where to save and do that all as before. And the great thing is this will work for as many images as I've got going. So let's go to another folder I've got here and I've got some images. And if I quick look at these images, you could see they're decent size. Let's go and select these and I'm going to control click quick actions and let's customize and let's add this. I only got to do this one time. Resize image files and now I control click quick actions resize image files. It should prompt me new image width. So let's make it something really small to make it obvious that we've made the change. Done. Now it's going to prompt me for where to save this to. I'm not going to save it to that PDFs location. I'm going to save it to the test directory here, right where those images were. So there's the original image. If I quick look at it, I can see it. And then if I go up one, I can see there's the smaller one. Now notice in here, one of the things I did is I clicked here and I changed the color and also the icon that's used for it. So that's a handy little thing to be able to do. Now here's one that works on something other than files. This is going to also be quick action, but it's going to receive text. So you can see I have all these things it can receive here. In this case, I've only selected text. And then if no text is selected, or maybe you run it some other way, it's going to ask for text. Then it's going to use make spoken audio. So that's something that is a action here in shortcuts. And then it's going to save that and do the same thing. So let's say now I have some text in any app and I select it. If I control click on it under services, I should see this appear here. There's text to spoken audio. And when I do that, it's going to prompt me now for a location to save this. So I'll save it to the desktop. And you can see it saves it here, gives it a name. And now that's an audio file.
To which Don Quixote replied, "Thou must take notice."
Now while we're here, I've got another action I created, something called response. So this is a little bit different. This is a shortcuts version of something I made in Automator a while ago. And what it does is it prompts you for some information and then formulates this response based on that information. Now, it's going to receive no input from quick actions, but it's going to be accessed as a quick action. Then it's going to ask you for text name and also ask you for text days to respond, and it's going to store those in variables. I shouldn't have to store those in variables. I should be able to do it in a better way. But as I said, shortcuts is a little buggy right now, so I had to resort to doing this. So I'm creating a variable called name and a variable called days. Then I'm running a JavaScript automation. So that's right, you can actually, under scripting here, find the ability to add AppleScript, JavaScript, or shell scripts in to your shortcuts. That's a very powerful feature of Automator that shortcuts has right off the bat. Then it's going to use a bit of JavaScript to call choose from list to have you make a choice out of three items. Then it's going to put that into a variable. Then it's going to create a list from those variables, name, days, and the variable called otherwise. And then it's going to use some JavaScript again to put that together in a piece of text and output it. So if we try that out in TextEdit here, I'll control click and choose response. It appears there as a quick action. I'll type a name. I'll click done. Number of days. I'll leave the default. And then I'll choose one of these and OK. And you can see it puts together the response just like it did when I used pretty much the same JavaScript in an Automator workflow to get the same task done. So here's another one I created. This one not as a quick action. And I'm just using it as an example of how you can do shell scripts inside of shortcuts. So here in the settings, I didn't select quick action but keep a menu bar. And this creates this little menu up here with shortcuts in it. So here all I'm doing is run shell script, which is a simple little task here. Run shell script, and you can see all it does is execute what's in there. So basically terminal commands, in other words. And I'm just running the one called uptime, which just gives you a report of how long your Mac has been awake. And it's just going to use show here, which if you look under show result, all that does is going to give you some output. Otherwise, the shortcut would do this, get the uptime, but never show it to you. So just put those two things together. So I can actually run this in the shortcuts app here and you can see what it does. But I could also exit from here, quit shortcuts completely, and then go here, uptime, and it's going to give me the results. So you can see that simple command giving results here, but imagine doing something much more complex in a shell script and then having it output the results for you like that and having easy access to it right here without having to go to the terminal. So I hope that gives an idea of what shortcuts is going to be capable of in macOS Monterey. It's going to be really powerful. It won't replace Automator right away. Like for instance, right now there's no folder actions and things like that. But you will be able to use it for a lot of the same things you do with Automator. And since you can do shell scripts, JavaScript, and ActionScript in it, I think there's going to be a ton of cool things we're going to be able to do with shortcuts on our Macs in a way that's going to be a little bit more accessible to people than using either Script Editor or Automator ever were. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.